as we talked about before, bicyclics basically come in two different categories. There's what I call the normal bicyclics, and what that would be is just one structure with two rings that are attached by one bond. All right, so I could say this is ring number one, this is ring number two. This would be a normal bicyclic. Then we have the other type of bicyclic called the bridged bicyclics, and these actually have three rings total. Okay, and I know it can be difficult to visualize, but basically imagine that you have one ring down here that is basically the bottom, the base, and then you'd have a second ring formed on this side, and then you'd have your last ring, your third ring, formed on that side. Okay, and what that means is that you have three rings that are all in this compound structure, and they're all connected by what this is called the bridgehead atoms. And remember that the bridgehead atoms are simply these right here. Okay, so we call that was bridgehead. Okay, now it can be difficult to visualize this, but it turns out that both of these structures, both the 3D one that I drew here and this one over here, are both the same thing. Okay, they're just two different ways to represent the same molecule. Basically, the bottom part down here, that's actually a cyclohexane that I've drawn right here. So that would be that blue part right there. And then the bridge, which is the part that comes over the top that I'm drawing in red, would be right here. Okay? So this is basically the 2D way to represent it, or planar. Okay? And this would be the 3D way to represent it. Okay? But in either case, they're both the same thing. So now let's go on and figure out how to name these guys. It turns out that bicyclics, because of their added complexity of multiple rings, are going to be named completely differently as monocycloalkanes.